We're very honored on this occasion with the presence of the President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, and I request Mr. S.R. Rao, Commerce Secretary, to welcome him with a bouquet of flowers. We're also privileged to welcome His Excellency Mikhail V. Myasnokovich, Honorable Prime Minister of Belarus, and I request Srimati Rita Menon, Chairperson and Managing Director, ITPO, to welcome him with a bouquet of flowers. We're also honored to welcome on the dais the Honorable Union Minister for Commerce and Industry and Textiles, Sri Anand Sharma, Her Excellency, the Deputy Trade and Industry Minister of South Africa, Ms. Elizabeth Thabet, the Honorable Chief Minister of Delhi, Srimati Sheela Dixit, the Honorable Chief Minister of Uttarakhand, Sri Vijay Bahuguna, the Honorable Minister of State for Commerce and Industry, Dr. P. Purandeshwari, the Honorable Lieutenant Governor of the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Lieutenant General Bhupinder Singh, Commerce Secretary, Sri S.R. Rao, also on the dais, the CMD ITPO, Madam Rita Menon, and the Executive Director ITPO, Sri Asit Kumar Tripathi.
His Excellency Mikhail Myasnokovich, Prime Minister of Belarus, Sri Anand Sharma, Minister of Commerce and Industry and Textiles, Srimati Sheela Dixit, Chief Minister of Delhi, Sri Vijay Bahuguna, Chief Minister Uttarakhand, Her Excellency Ms. Elizabeth Thabet, Deputy Minister of Trade and Industry, South Africa, Srimati D. Purandeshwari, Minister of State for Commerce, Lieutenant General Bhupinder Singh, Lieutenant Governor of Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Sri S.P. Rao, Commerce Secretary, Srimati Rita Menon, Chairperson and Managing Director, India Trade Promotion Organization, Sri A.K. Tripathi, Executive Director, India Trade Promotion Organization, Ambassadors, High Commissioners, Excellencies, Distinguished Guests, Ladies and Gentlemen. It's indeed a pleasure for me to be here at the inauguration ceremony of the India International Trade Fair, the flagship event of India Trade Promotion Organization that is opening its 32nd edition today. My mind goes back to 32 years ago, when, at a much younger stage, I had the privilege of initiating this international trade fair as the then Commerce Minister in 1980. Of course, as Commerce Minister has already explained, Indian economy has undergone a sea change in these last 30 years, and India is emerging as an important player, as emerging market economy, and being a member of the important economic group G20. It was only yesterday whole of our country celebrated the festival of light, Diwali. Festival signifies not only the victory of good over evil, but also the banishment of the forces of darkness and ignorance, and welcoming the light of enlightenment. I am happy to say that IITF, over the last 3 decades, has significantly contributed towards enlightening the world about the narration of India's growth. It has acted as a vehicle for showcasing India's economic and social development over the last 3 decades, while itself gaining its popularity and moving from strength to strength, I congratulate the management of India International Trade Fair. Economic changes necessarily have social ramifications. In order to keep pace with the rapid global changes, we need to constantly fine-tune the skills of our workforce. There is an urgent need to bring skill development and vocational training to the center stage of our development process. In order to reach the target of skilling 500 million persons by the year 2022, it is necessary that apart from government agencies, industry-led fora address the issue of integrating skilled manpower and the mainstream of economic growth. India has been a model of self-reliance and a source of inspiration to many developing countries. Our relentless struggle to overcome poverty, illiteracy, and ill health has been watched with keen interest by the international community. The fact that a country with a primarily agro-based economy and a burgeoning population could make its presence felt in diverse fields such as information technology, heavy industries, communications, nuclear energy, space research, electronics, etc., has been acknowledged and admired the world over. It is heartening to note that India's external trade, that is merchandise exports plus imports, as a proportion of the GDP, has more than doubled from less than 20% at the turn of the last century to around 45% in the recent years. It is also a matter of satisfaction that India's export registered a fivefold increase in the last decade from $44.6 billion in 2000 to $306 billion in 2011-12. The compound annual growth rate of India's exports, which was 8.2% in the 90s, increased to around 20% during the 2000-2001 to 2008-09. India's share of global exports has also increased from 0.7% in 2000 to 1.5% in 2010. Its ranking in leading exports improved from 31st position to 20th position in 2010. This has been possible through the considerable diversion in its export basket and its export destinations with countries in Asia and Africa, gaining ground relatively over Europe and USA. The government has also recently traveled and unveiled several policy measures designed to put the economy back on a high growth trajectory. Important among these has been the decisions to allow foreign direct investment in multi-brand retail trade and the civil aviation sector, and seek the legislative approval for increasing FDI cap in the insurance and pension sectors. Simultaneously, measures have also been announced to keep government subsidy burden in check, thereby bringing about a reduction in the fiscal deficit. These measures would help in restoring the economy's growth momentum. Trade fairs of the type and scale of the India International Trade Fair have few parallels. IITF, during its course of 3 decades, has been a successful launching pad for a large number of consumer products, cars, durables, consumer electronics, appliances, housing, to name a few. Most importantly, however, the fair has been an excellent platform for small and micro enterprises to showcase their products and penetrate both domestic and international markets at attractive prices without compromising with quality. As you know, these MSMEs are a source of rural empowerment, which is one of the key objectives of government's agenda for inclusive growth. I'm happy to note that this year's theme of the IITF is Skilling India. It needs to mention that the skill building is an integral part of the nation's economic progress. ITPO has done commendable work in bringing all stakeholders together to share their experiences at this important event. In my last tenure as the Union Finance Minister, I still recall that we operationalized the National Skill Development Corporation in October 2009 with a target of skilling 150 million persons. Since then, it has covered a lot of ground. The corporation has already made a funding commitment to more than Rs. 1,200 crores for various projects that are expected to train 62 million persons in the next 10 years and augment vocational training capacity of 125 million persons per year in private sector. By March 2012, the National Skill Development Corporations had opened 500 permanent and 2,500 mobile centers in 220 districts across the 24 states, thereby imparting training to 89,500 persons. I'm sure the National Skill Development Corporation will continue to build on these initiatives. Finally, I would like to quote a few words from Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, who is considered as the architect of modern India, on whose birthday we celebrate today by opening the India International Trade Fair. I quote, "We live in a wonderful world that is full of beauty, charm, and adventures. There is no end to adventures we can have if only we seek them with our eyes open," unquote. I'm pleased to know that Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Belarus, China, Cuba, Iran, Pakistan, Papua New Guinea, Sri Lanka, South Africa, and Thailand have set up the national pavilion at this trade fair, and about 480 overseas exhibitors from 22 countries are participating in this year's event. I extend my heartfelt greetings and good wishes to all the participants and visitors from abroad to the 32nd India International Trade Fair and declare the fair open. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Jai Hind.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the formal inaugural function.